Do you ever look at these fancy 3D crests and shields done by big broadcasters for sports events and wish there was a way to create these 3D crests for your brand, clients, or even your local basketball tournament? Well, today I'm going to show you how you can use our sports crests and shields templates pack to make your very own custom 3D crests and shields. Ali here from Sports Templates, and today I'm bringing you guys a new template, new idea. I've never done anything like this before. This time we made a new product showing different 3D crests, so you can use these for your own clients, special tournament, or just if you want to announce something in a really fancy 3D way. So this pack comes with 3D templates. We have the first one like this. In 4 minutes or 5 minutes, I was able to take this design into something that looks like this. This is the second crest. It features the jersey texture on the backplate here, and it also took me 4 or 5 minutes to create this version of it. The lights can be turned on or off, and if you zoom in, you can just see the level of details that we put into these. Everything is built in 3D to make sure you get the best quality possible with these templates. We even have small thumbprints and little scratches on the metal materials here, and these 3D texts are 100% editable inside of Photoshop. So you'll be able to create a professional looking 3D crest all inside of Photoshop without even having to use any 3D program. The third template is this one. Also comes with these foam fingers. You can turn on number one on them, turn it off, or you could just hide them all together. Also, if you look at these little stadium lights on the crest, you can turn them on and off. And just to show you the level of details, we went through these templates. If you notice at this ledge here, when you turn on the lights, you can see the light reflection. This is something that's probably not necessary, but we just obsess over these things, and we spend a few hours just to make sure that this is added in. So in today's tutorial, we're gonna take this 3D crest template, and we're gonna make it into a Super Bowl announcement social media post. I built these helmets using another helmet template that we've done. You can look it up on our website. It's called the Riddell Speedflex helmet template. And to make things easier, I've already created this little library that I'm gonna share the link of it in the description below so you can follow along step by step. So to get started, we can go to editable parts right here, go to crest, and just start from the bottom, go up. So here we have the top ornament, which is this one. Let's make the outer frame this silver color. So we can just select it, click on the color, became silver, go up one, that's the same thing. And then the bottom ornament is also going to be silver as well. Now, the second frame needs to be black, the third frame, black, and then the fourth frame needs to be red. Now, the crest needs to be black, but it has this smart layer on top of it, so we can just turn it off. Then left separator padding needs to be black, separator is red, another padding is black, and the separator is red. And that's pretty much it for the base crest. Now moving on to the lights. Let's turn off the lights now just so we can see the details under them, and let's zoom in a little bit. So the lights, we can go here. The base needs to be black as well. Lights, black, and light caps can be any color, but for now I'm just gonna leave them white. So it really depends on what you need, but I'm gonna leave them this off-white color. Now we move on to the main banner. So with the main banner, we need to start adding colors to it. So let's start with the outer frame. It needs to be black. Main board, black as well. But it has this banner design, so we'll just remove it so we can see what we're dealing with. Then the board frame, black as well. Then the banner padding, that needs to be black as well. And then this debossed version of the frame needs to be red. Top ornament, we can make it silver. And that's pretty much it for the main banner. Secondary banner, we're doing the same thing. Outer frame is black, but for the banner, we're gonna do it red. And we're gonna do the padding part black to kind of invert the design we did at top. Now, what's left is this text. First, let's do the main text here. It's in its own layer because it's 3D and it has its own effects. So we can go to add main text here, double click to open it up. It says Thursday night here, then double click and just say Super Bowl instead. If you turn on extras, you can see the edges that I've set up for you, so you know if you, as long as you're inside these guides, your text is gonna stay within the banner. So we can make our text a little bit wider and a little bit bigger. So something like this looks nice. Let's bring it down a little bit to look more centered. All right, now let's save it. All right, if you zoom in to see the details, you can see that the text looks as if it's 3D, but this is a trick we did to make it look like that. You can see the shadows here on a separate layer. You can play with the shadows if you want more. If you want harsher shadows or softer shadows, you can just go in here and edit the effects of these layers to fit your design. Also, you have this scratches layer, which you can make stronger or lighter based on what you need for your design. So here we're making it stronger if you want more reflective title, or we can make it lighter. It's up to you and the design you're trying to make. So once we're done with the main text, we can go back to secondary banner here and go to grid. Double click. Here it says team versus team, so we can just write Chiefs versus San 49ers. And there we have it. These grids wrap around the whole banner, so it's not just for adding text. You can also add any kind of shape. So for example, if you want to add some sort of a pattern at the back, you can do any kind of shape. Maybe like a shape like this, repeat it a few times, and save. You can see we got this kind of pattern going on here. We can, if you change the colors, maybe we get something more interesting. So maybe let's try black, something like this, save it. And we got something that looks like this. But for now, I'm just gonna turn it off and keep the text on their own. What's left is the bottom ornament here. So we just make it silver as well. And we can go on to work on the crest logos. So we go to crest logos here, double click, turn on the grid to see what we're doing. So to help guide you with these placeholder logos as a reference to where you should add your own logos. So for the NFL logo, we kind of put it on top of this your logo placeholder. Right, let's center it right here, hide the logo. Then let's add the Fox Sports logo, kind of center it up top here. I've added a placeholder logo here so you can get an idea. So, okay, turn it off, turn off the grid, and save it. That's pretty much it with the logos. If you zoom in, you can see that these logos look as if they are part of the crest. They're casting shadows and reflections. Same thing here. Since they have a similar lighting setup and effects, now that we're done with the basic designs, we can just turn the lights back on and see how they look on this color scheme. One more thing you can do is I have this lights layer, so you can have an extra stadium lights. If you want to add to this design, you can add it here or hide it. You can also add foam fingers on the back. These foam fingers are totally editable. So you can just go to the right finger, click on this layer, and then click red, turns red. If you want the number one on it, you can turn it on from here. And then you go on the other one, make it gold, and then turn on the number one on it. One for 49ers and one for the Chiefs. What's left now is the helmets, which I've done using my previous template. So I can just bring them from here and just drag them into my design here, drag them down onto the grass. Then to make space for them, let's bring everything up a little bit. All right. Now, one more thing I want to show you is that this template comes with dynamic lighting. So it's this layer. You can go inside and you can control if you need any extra lights on the template. You can control them here, see how they look, go to the hue saturation, and you can change the direction of where the light is coming from. So if you want some light that's coming from the left side like this, you can just do something like this. Control the intensity, the spread of the light, and if we save it, it's gonna look like an extra layer of light on top of our crest. You can turn it on or off, or you can even change the color of the light. So if you go to hue saturation and do colorize, you can change the color of the extra light that you're adding. If you want to give it like an extra hue, it's all up to you. So that was it for our template today. Hope you guys like these crests. Let me know if you want me to make more of these. This is just something new that we're trying with these templates. See if you guys like them. Don't forget to drop a like and a subscribe. Let us know which sports crest you'd like to make using these templates, and follow us on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and see you guys on the next one.